Hello everyone! Today we will be covering how to use the Visual Styles palette to control surfaces, edges, and the environment in FormIt. Let's begin by selecting the Visual Styles palette from the palette toolbar, which defaults to the Surfaces tab. From here, we can adjust the ambient brightness, which controls the overall brightness of all materials in the scene. A value of 100 means materials exposed to light will display at their full brightness as defined in the material's color or texture. Values over 100 will overexpose the material. The ambient contrast controls how much darker faces in shade appear when compared to faces exposed to direct sunlight. A value of 0 means that lighting has no effect. All materials will appear at their full brightness regardless of orientation, whereas higher values will make faces in shade appear increasingly darker. The default value is 25. We can turn on shadows, which will tie the sun and shadow settings for the location, date, and time. The shadow intensity controls how dark the shadows appear on the ground plane and other faces. A value of 0 will make shadows effectively invisible, and a value of 100 will make shadows black. The default value is 20. We can turn on ambient shadows to add a touch of shading to corners, giving realism to your FormIt model. And monotone surfaces disables the color and texture of all materials and makes the surrounding environment white. Watch as the materials on the pyramid and cube change to white when checked on. And next we have surface colors. The faces default to white, but you can change them globally to any color by clicking on the color box and selecting a new color. If we turn on back faces, we won't see any gray because these are primitive solids, but if I use the reverse face tool, you will see it turn gray, and you can also change this color to whatever you would like. Now let's click the Edges tab. The contrast of the edges affects how visible they are, and the default value is 60. You can also pick a color of the edges, which will change them globally and is defaulted to black. You can change the line weight of the edge by checking on thick edges, and this will make the edge lines bolder. If we leave on thick edges and check on sketchy edges, you can see how the lines are given a variable thickness and appear to be more hand-drawn. Hidden edges will show a wireframe of the solids. Extended edges will draw the edges past the vertex of a solid to make the model more sketch-like. Silhouettes control edges that touch air, making them a bold profile. You can toggle them on and change the contrast to determine their visual impact. Lastly, we have the Environment tab, which controls the general canvas items. You can turn the grid on and off. When off, this will disable the snap to grid option. Axes control the display of the XYZ axes at the world origin. If you have levels in the levels palette, this will toggle them on and off in view. The fog that helps define the depth of the canvas can be turned off, and the north arrow will be pinned on the bottom left hand of the canvas and will follow you as you rotate, if checked on. The environment colors can be useful when setting up scenes and animation. You can toggle the sky on or off and control the colors, so if this were a sunset view, I could change the upper to a light red, the middle to a light orange, and the lower to a light yellow. If I wanted the ground plane to look like grass, I could change it to green, but I can also toggle off the ground plane. When selecting these colors, there is a button here called Pick Screen Color, and once activated, the crosshairs will pick any color from any screen or program you have open. You can click to pick it, and it will be applied. You can also add custom color swatches here, or utilize RGB or HSV. The workplane options will apply when using the Set Axes tool in the context menu, and also when editing groups. If we change it to pink and then edit the group, my workplane has changed to this color. The Diagnostic tab is reviewed in the Visual Styles Model Diagnostics video, and that's it for FormIt Visual Styles Palette. Be sure to check out more videos on the FormIt YouTube channel.